Okay, I remember that there's a fembot over there, and then there's a murder bot over there, and then there's another murder bot over there. My headphones on here and get the audio up. Let's. All right. Nope. I don't even know what got me. I think that was a prox mine. Let's go ride bikes. I don't know, isn't everybody's favorite Mega Man Mega Man 2 though? That's the one that everybody likes the music from. 3 is the one I played most growing up. I'm pretty sure I quick loaded their game. The majority can in fact be very wrong. Very, very wrong. Just look at all those GURPS fans out there. Ah, my ass. Wow, we are so close to death. We need to heal. The ancient DOS part. Oh, man. I don't remember. God, what was the channel? I saw some channel review that game, and holy God, it looks bad. I mean, Mega Man 3 just had kind of good music across the board. Yeah, I know in the Nintendo, yeah, like BCAT says, it's 2, 3, and 4 that everybody's like, these are the good ones. What the fuck? What's going on? I'm confused. Where is she? Where is she? Showdown, stop with the DW Bradleyisms. I'm trying to hear the evil robots. We shall never speak again. All right, quick save for cowardice. That's like the... What the hell is that? It has a gun. That's like the Amiga port of Castlevania, though, right? Hila tried to play that. I would love to watch his playthrough for it, but the audio is completely jacked and it triggers the shit out of me. I'm gonna play it one of these days. It just requires me to put forth the effort of, you know, getting an Amiga emulator. I know you like GURPS, BCAT. That's why I rag on it. One of these days... One of these days, I'm gonna just pick up a GURPS rulebook, and that's just gonna be the stream. It's me figuring out GURPS, and you can sit there and handhold me through it, because I'm gonna have no idea what I'm doing. Could you imagine Shodan just, like, hacks into your audio and just screams? That's it. It's just non-stop, like, incoherent screaming. No, spark beam. I mean, I think it'd be funny, and then it would be very not funny. Where is it? That's the thing, like, yeah, the Amiga Castlevania, it's wrong. It's just wrong. That game is a curse. Have I seen X-Men 97? I have not seen X-Men 97. I want to because I am a huge fan of the old X-Men cartoon. And it kills me that it's like impossible to find. But it's one of those things that part of me wonders if it's better to just leave it in the past. I was expecting that to drop that dude, but okay. Oh, more or less did. Okay. All right. Good talk. I like this ion rifle a lot. Get some money. The entire series is on Disney Plus. Of the original X-Men? Really? I thought they had like completely divested themselves from it and wanted everybody to forget it even existed. Holy shit. Oh, damn. Well. I mean, far be it from me to give money to Disney, but that is very good to know. Yeah. Oh, I didn't see you. X-Men 97 continues where it left off. Oh, that's really fucking cool. Okay. I've seen a couple clips from X-Men 97 and it looks real good. Like, it looks like OG X-Men. I mean, obviously it's not going to be the exact same, but it looks pretty fucking good. Went in ready to hate it. Fair enough. I saw an asshole with a proximity mine down there. Where'd you go? Man, you Christ. Thick glasses. Okay. I have no idea where we're going on this level. I did get a grenade. What is that, EMP? Sure, why not? Any of the rogue doesn't have as much butt. Oh my god! Yeah, you cheeky fuckers. None of that. I hear the thing talking. Yeah, I know exactly what you guys are talking about. Well, Ela, in that case, I mean, yo-ho, yo-ho. I mean, anymore, you can just, like, Google whatever stream and you'll find it. Okay, so this area just seems like... Oh, side doors. The number of folks hit sudden puberty.
Fresh meat.
Hey, Hurricut, thank you. Very much appreciated. 16 months. Hell yeah. No, where's my mag pulse? I think that thing's got a shield up. Man! Hey, only I can strafe corners. Son of a bitch. That connects back up to the main corridor. This music is bopping. I think this is the most music we've gotten in a single stint in the entire time we've been playing this. Where'd that thing go? Because this isn't it. This is the one we killed earlier. Oh, there it is! Nope! You. Man! Almost a year. Almost. Almost. That's a little more than a year, Hurricut. A little more than a year. Teflon rounds. Okay. Yes, I did put down that black dragon. That was not a particularly good fight, but yes, we managed. We managed eventually. I just had to respec everybody to hit points, and that was... apparently the required strategy. And getting the double damage against dragons for killing that other dragon. Whoa, where did you come from, sir? My hit points. That hurt. Monster closets. Sly Cooper reboot. I've actually never played any of the Sly Cooper games. That's literally a monster closet. Cheesy fuckers. Frame rate. Seems like the case for- yeah, exactly. That's exactly what it's a case for. Go ahead, do I have... batteries? I don't actually- oh no, I do have some batteries. Okay, yeah, we're gonna reload. Okay.
Letting go was best.
That auto blade. It's pretty good. Pretty dang good. Been for an endless spin-off, mostly because surprisingly Scooby-Doo had one movie they could make a mini-series called Scooby-Doo. I fucking loved that movie! Ghoul School was so good! Oh my god. Everybody's like, hey, what's your favorite Scooby-Doo movie? And nowadays it's all the ones with the, everybody goes for the ones that's got, like, the teenage vampires or whatever the fuck. And as per protocol, everybody just gets super horny. And it's just like, no, Ghoul School, classic. I probably haven't seen that movie since I was like 10. The cyborg ladies remind me of your ex. I'm sorry. I am sorry. Take some free batteries. And the music is going hard. This is the most music we've had, I think, in this entire playthrough. What? What? Oh, Jesus. I didn't even see you there, little buddy. Hey, for effort. Yeah, I have no idea what that does, but okay. I just heard a security beep. All right. That's locked. I imagine we do not have access. Here. Energy efficient mod kit for the RW45. What is that? Oh, that's for our pulse rifle. Okay, yeah. Hell yeah. Gimme. What's it do? Reduces energy cost. Why, yes. I'm curious how much. Let's see. Oh, tier 2 shot only takes 1 energy now. That's very exciting. That was the only complaint I had about this thing, is that it is crazy hungry for the energy. P, proximity mines. Oh, I'm liking this room. It's just all bullets. Okay. Ghoul School had a potential. Wouldn't even be that far a stretch to make it happen. Stop the help of one day. Well, yeah. But I mean, that was, I don't know, kind of a different time when it came to animated stuff. In that they were kind of just throwing everything out there and seeing what stuck. It is a shame they didn't do more with it, though. Railgun projectiles, magcore pulse rounds. Frag grenades, alright! I mean, this room's been great! This is obviously a door that's going to open and probably release something that wants to kick my shit in. Game, I don't need... I don't feel threatened right now, I don't need the techno rock. Oh, did I just... Well, this would be unfortunate if we didn't have hover boots. Ah. I wonder if that's what that lever up there did. Yeah, I agree with you on that, drunk bot. I miss the originality in a lot of things. It's all basically come down to stuff being so expensive to produce that nobody takes risks anymore. And because of that, everything is all just, you know, designed by committee and fucking boring. Ow. Bro. Where the fuck? Okay, there he is. I was gonna say, where did he go? Plasma core, magnesium rounds. That I actually, wow, none of this. I don't want any of it. That's saddening. Jerry Porras, the voice of Showdown, became a game designer. Really? Did animation for the Dishonored series. That's fucking cool. Good for her. I'm glad. Hell yeah. Or is manually locked. I mean, that's the way of it, ain't it? Like, everybody's, like, these big companies are all about, you know, copy-pasting stuff with just a different coat of skin, whereas if you want the creativity and stuff, now you've got to go for the indies. And I mean, I'm okay with that. You've seen that every so often, like, a big-name studio will do something trying to capture that. Like, Ubisoft, for example, they did Might and Magic 10. I mean, it was years ago. But they try to do something different, or Far Cry Blood Dragon, where it was Far Cry in name, but the game was way pared down, and it was something you could beat reasonably quickly. And, you know, the games were well received, it's just that they're not making, you know, their ridiculous fucking Roomba. They're just not making the ridiculous profit margins that they're expecting. But I do agree that having, you know, these games made by hundreds and hundreds of people, I think it's ridiculous. I mean, it's good to have jobs, but at the same time, with how things are now, they just fire them as soon as the game's done anyways. Hey, Sel. But yes, basically agree, Dila. AAA, crash and burn. And then, you know, you top that with, like, not only is the development cost and stuff crazy overbloated, now they want $70 for a game, and for that $70, you're getting a game that's probably going to be, you know, designed as a games as a service. It's going to have a bunch of DLC and monetization stuff, and it's just like, why? Why would I want to buy into that? It's ridiculous. I don't want a game to be my life. Crazy. So when The Last Epoch was complaining that they ran out of content 3 hours into the game. Yeah, exactly. Like, that shit is so dumb. And it's not just Last Epoch, it's any game. And, you know, gamers nowadays, they expect, you know, you spend X dollars on a game and then you have the expectation it's going to get years of updates and stuff. And people are so averse to just buying a game, having the game, and that's what you get for your dollary dues. It's crazy. And it's not just Last Epoch, it's a bunch of games. Like, fuck, RuneScape. People are, like, calling RuneScape a dead game because it's getting, you know, much less frequent updates. But the problem is that the game itself, if you want to max your account, that is thousands of hours of playtime. For normal people, probably tens of thousands of hours of playtime. And it's just like, what? Good God. Are we talking about how Blizzard said they need 900? No, we're just talking about how AAA devs are shit. I saw tab out here for just a second. See, Haraza asks, what are games I am looking forward to playing next? I've been having a lot of fun with Helldivers 2. Me and the dwarf have been playing that. As for games that are coming out that I'm looking forward to, off the top of my head, I'm looking forward to the new DLC for RimWorld. that's probably going to get another, I don't know, 50 or 100 hours of play out of me. But past that, not a lot. I was excited for Dragon's Dogma 2, and I am looking forward to playing it, but I'm not going to pay $70 for it. I refuse to pay $70 for video games. I think it's just absolutely ridiculous. So I'll probably wait for that to come down or go on sale. It's not like I'm in a hurry. I'm really looking forward to the DLC for Elden Ring. I had a lot of fun with Elden Ring. I've probably put like 200 hours into that thing. Past that, I mean, I could check really quick. What do I have on my Steam wish list? I'm mostly a PC gamer. I don't really do much in the realm of console gaming anymore. I've got Call of Serignar, which is like Betrayal at Krondor. I'm looking forward to Farthest Frontier. It's not necessarily my kind of game, but it's by the guys that made Grim Dawn, and it's a city builder. I do enjoy city builders. It's out in early access. I just tend to like to wait. And then there's a game. It was actually suggested to me called Mystic Land, The Search for Mafaldo, that is kind of a party-based dungeon crawler that looks pretty cool. And past that, not too much. I'm set in my ways. My general gaming is, you know, I'll play DDO, I'll play Helldivers, I play Deep Rock Galactic, that kind of stuff. A lot of old things. Most of the games I play anymore are super, super old stuff. I've streamed Cell, you're rocking it, man. Get those Kelvin's coins. What can you do after the 30 hours of fun in RuneScape? Yeah, exactly. Just a dead game. Completely ignore those 30 hours. Like, it's like it's an addiction. And good God, people need help. Not every game is meant to take up your life, and that's okay. My God, more than one. Yeah, that's it. It's a nifty looking game. Like, I like the aesthetic. I just hope it's good. You're not, you don't like the... It's not just the cosmic horror stuff that's interesting to me in it. For me, the one I'm most excited about is actually the zombies that it adds, because I like zombie survival, and having zombie survival RimWorld, yeah, okay, I'll give that a try. Oh, we got this key. Mafaldo sounds like Waldo, oh God. Experimental teleport? How bad could it be? The music is finally fucking stopped. And hear myself think. Okay, is this the one that's gonna like telefrag us? No, it just zips us back here, which maybe we can get into there now. This way. Hey, Metal Bianco, good to see you. Hope you're doing well, man. Yeah, most of the stuff I follow, it's like it's just indie stuff anymore, because AAA is, I don't know, it's gotten so right by the numbers or color by the numbers that, like, I used to like Assassin's Creed. The last Assassin's Creed I really enjoyed was Origins, the one in Egypt. That game was just a ton of fun. Loved the setting, love running around, you know, turn your brain off and do sneaky shit. Fun. I used to like Far Cry, then Far Cry 3 happened. And I enjoyed Far Cry 3, but then every Far Cry since Far Cry 3 has been trying to be Far Cry 3, and I don't want more Far Cry 3. So, yeah, I don't know. I mean, like, Baldur's Gate 3, I'm not super excited for. I know everybody's in love with it, but I shouldn't shit on it as much as I do. Although I guess the shitting I give is more a light ribbing, because I should at least try playing it. But that game, I think, the game is either too horny for its own good or the community is, because all I ever see about that game is just a bunch of horny shit. And when people call them on it, the other people are like, the game's not that horny, really. But that's all anybody ever shows, so I don't know. Seriously, nothing down here. All right. have a demanding job, have hardly any time for gaming. Yes, I feel you on that. Basically, the only gaming I do is this stream and my Let's Plays. I hang out with friends a couple times a month, and we get, you know, maybe part of an evening in, but that's largely about it. And it's been even less lately because work has been crazy, which has been cutting into my game dev time because I would really like to actually start working on my games more. Oh my god, dude, just die. Go down. My god, it's impervious. People with kinks that make almost anything horny. Any game can be horny if you want. I mean, I suppose so. But yeah, like, that's the thing is, it's one of those, it's like, oh, the game's not horny. Well, then show me that. But all anybody ever shows is all the innuendo and shit. And it's like, man, I don't care. Oh, that was cool. I mean, not cool, but cool that it blew my grenade up mid-throw. There's a numbered rule relating to this, probably, yeah. When in doubt, sword. Holy hell! He is so beefy. Okay. Actually stuck. I stuck the proximity mine on it. Whoop. How is aiming done? So I think what the game is trying to tell me is that I shouldn't be going this way, but I'm a stubborn ass and that shit ain't flying. Yeah, that's the thing, Ela. Where's your OnlyFans playing all the weird titty dungeon crawlers? Ela the Perving Cat. There you go. I even named your channel for you. You're welcome. I'll expect my check in the mail. Okay. Oh. I was wondering why my rapier didn't kill that thing, and I just realized I have no energy. That'd do it. Not dead, alright. Normally two or three mag pulse rounds puts those guys down, but apparently not this one. Or Let's Plays on Pornhub, hey. Probably do worse. Ooh, boots level 3 increases the vertical thrust. Oh, hell yeah. Let me just fucking fly around with these things. I'm excited. My body is ready. I wish that I could turn on the vertical thrust with these, but not have the move speed on them. Hey, look at that! That's some pretty good. That's like 3 stories. Nice. 3 levels, I guess. I'll take it. Killing Shodan 30 years ago, vaguely. I never beat the original. Well, no, I take that back. I never beat the original System Shock, like, near when it came out. I played the shit out of this, but I wasn't. I was like 10, probably younger than that when this came out. So, of course, the game bored me to tears. Then I played it in high school. High school is when I really did a lot of my playthroughs of games that I played growing up and then never finished and actually got progress in them. Okay, so this is just a little undercroft. It feels strange that there's just nothing down here. All right. So Looks like they're trying to ban the hot tub stuff. I mean, I know that, like, the current new thing is you basically show your ass off. Like, the ethots are just constantly testing the waters, and once one of them finds any purchase, the rest of the horde just descends on it. It's just like, good God. Like, if you want to do that shit, have the fucking stones to just do it on a fucking porn site. But no, they won't do that because Twitch is letting them get away with it. Sigh. Okay, well, we know there's robots here and I have grenades. Let's employ them. Oh shit, I was expecting them to kill you! They're so beefy! That's one. Oh no, that was both of them. We're good. We're good. That Twitch is important. Yeah, exactly. It's gotten so bad. Assault rifle ammo. Where are you? Hello, Shodan. Is this more of Shodan's farts? Oh, it is.
My children, the security level is to be laid out in this manner and no other. First, remove the lower elevator that provides access to the access to the bridge and my domain. Second, the balconies and force bridges shall all be removed, save for one, to the central shaft, where all incoming life forms shall be monitored.
Okay. You tell him, Shodan. Yeah.
My body. You. You don't understand.
Everyone read it just for the articles. I mean, supposedly back in the day, the articles were actually worth reading. I mean, I've seen some old articles from Playboy, and there was some, I wouldn't use the word racy to describe it, but critical things in there, things that you probably wouldn't see in other magazines because it would be considered against thoughts against the grain. I mean, I suppose there should be a place for all that. It just happened to be in a titty mag. Oh no, cyberspace locks. I don't wanna. You can't make me. Okay, well, at least we have easy access to a recharge station. That counts for something. Titties and knowledge. Hey, whatever. Whatever gets the brain flowing. Oh no. Oh. Oh no. Alright. So what do we got? So I know this one has two, this one has two, that one has one, that one has one. Okay, so it looks like we need, I assume, all the way up here. So what is that? 4, 5, 6, 7. There's only six, so we're gonna have to split it somewhere. Maybe do this. Nope. This here, and then this here. I don't think I need this other two yet. There we go. See? We've learned! Progress! Well, yeah, I don't imagine it was the youth reading the articles. We all know what the youth was looking at Playboy for. Made it more effective in cutaway knowledge. Exactly! Who needs to think when you can just consume instead? Isn't it so much more enjoyable to just consume? Oh, there's another loop back to the main corridors. Holy shit! The level design in this game is so good when it's not just completely bewildering me. Reflex. I'll take the universal antidote. The hell is that? Oh, ammo. And Lachete, a shotgun. I believe Teflon's for our pistol, isn't it? Or, yeah, the scorpion. So much ammo. I'm actually sitting pretty good on supplies right now. I'm just not using any of them. Says the LPR to his watchers. I mean, this is kind of a little bit different, though, isn't it? Than just, you know, watching a movie or whatever because there's interaction. I don't completely ignore you guys. This isn't a hot tub stream. You don't have to sacrifice bits for me to notice you. Oh, another key card. Except for Ela. Ela needs to sacrifice bits.
I'm a pretty dwarf.
Ghost feet tower hot tub. Notice me, senpai. I have witnessed you, Ela. I like how even Geistbot is shitting on you. He's like, thanks for donating 0 bits. Oh, I wonder. I gotta get something programmed in specifically for when Ela donates bits, that if he doesn't donate like at least 100, Geistbot's just like, thanks for nothing, pay pig. Except Ela would probably get off on that. It's fucking cat. It's those fucking floating point number rounding errors. One person pays bits to get ghosts in a hot tub, another donates to make me stay out. There was a point in time where I was floating the idea of allowing chat to ban Celt at a whim. And then having like the ban cost 1,000, right? And then the unban would be like 1. Just to be a pain in the ass. That was that fucking Roomba. It respawned. God damn it. It's a fucking game. Bonk, no. You're not the boss of me, Celt. You're not my dad. We've been down there. Security is 83. Holy shit. That's a busy level. Delta's fucked. Alpha is open. Beta is locked. Gamma is locked. Are these locked? Oh, ho. Oh man, I assume this is going to power from the bottom because get fucked, kid, that's why. Let's find out. Just give me like any, of course. Okay, are there any extra? There are not. All right. Oh man. Right? Like, why doesn't Shodan just cook the hacker's brain at any moment? There we go. See, we're learning! Look at that, isn't it crazy? Oh, fuck! Jesus. Thankfully, I have cat-like reflexes and was able to sidestep out, headshotting it in the process. Oh, I wonder if we're gonna get a med bay on this level, like an actual medical bay. Warlocks. Warlocks. Gib healing. Device makes it so she can't. I suppose that would make sense. As soon as an enemy is on your ship, open the doors and let them be. Yeah. Oh, we do totally get a healing pot. Oh, thank God. She's gonna turn us into a fucking pickle in here. That was like, I'm not a huge fan of FTL, but that game had some really cool concepts in it, and being able to just vent atmosphere in your entire ship was one of them. Okay, what else do we have?
Cyborg conversion canceled. Standard station restoration procedures online.
No more conversion, only man. Beep, beep. I didn't even see that thing. I was looking specifically for whatever. Okay, so they're giving me everything here, which leads me to believe that there's bullshit afoot. Okay, I want this guy. Give. She's crazy and think the hacker is no danger, so she can play with him. I don't know. She's been telling her robots to kill us this whole time. Yeah, FTL. I got to the final boss, and I beat him. And then phase two started, and I got fucking bent over, and that was the last time I played FTL. Because fuck that shit. I beat the first phase. I won the game. I saw the end credits. Just not the way they wanted me to. So I'm curious how we get into those. Okay, so we came from Alpha. I don't think we've been on this level. Although looking at it, it doesn't really look like there's anything down there. Some corpses. I don't even know what I'm supposed to be doing on this level. I'm just poking around. Oh, this is open. Okay. Oh, this, I think. I'm so confused. This was locked. I think it was. We must have opened it at some point. Neat. Esports. 100% intentional. With the right set. Well, yeah, of course. I mean, that's kind of like the whole roguelike thing. You know, you get a good run going and then just kind of blast them out. Fucking cyberspace lock. I do not want to do cyberspace. It's the same as saying you beat the first form. Hey, if you beat Dracula, it's not your fault that there was the demi Dracula fight after it. Where the hell is cyberspace though? Well, there's doors up here we can check. Oh, hey. Problem is getting set up. Yeah, exactly. And that's one of the reasons that, like, here we go. One of the reasons I don't really play too many roguelikes anymore is that my gaming time is so sparse now. Woo! That I don't want to invest, you know, a bunch of time into a run and then just get gibbed by something that I either didn't see coming or had no way to avoid because, haha, it's a roguelike. Although most newer games are kind of a good bit better about not nailing you with that kind of shit. It's not like ADOM or, you know, the old NetHacks where, you know, You're carrying a cockatrice, and you fall down a flight of stairs, and it bumps you and stones you. Nope. Get up there. Physics, what are you even doing? Oh my god. Up. What is this? Oh, flechetti rounds. No fucks given. What else do we have? There's something here. More flechetti, it is. So with these upgraded boots, I can probably go back to all of those old areas with the night dive helmets and find them. But no. Love running ions, fun to watch things choking. Yeah, exactly. That's the thing. It's like Elo was saying, you know. Who needs air? We don't need air. Our enemies do. Are they like setting all the rooms on fire? Good times. I need to pick up Dwarf Fortress. I still haven't picked up the Steam release of Dwarf Fortress. Maybe do some let's dick around with Dwarf Fortress. That might be an adventure. I don't know. I don't know if I have Dwarf Fortress in me anymore. Oh god. The endless dwarf puns. I do it on stream. Name dwarves after all of you and watch you get eaten by giant cave spiders. Ow. Or whatever new horrors they've added. It's been so long since I've played Dwarf Fortress. I would. Oh, God. I'll find another one of those fucking things. Brainwash the pilot and make him take the ship apart. Hell yeah. Dwarf Fort's Masterwork mod gets an update. I would assume that the Steam version of Dwarf Fortress is do mods for the, I guess, standalone version work with the Steam version too? I would assume not, but I honestly don't know. Oh. An elevator. The executive. What the hell? Oh, this is where we came in. I just did a big fucking circle. Holy shit. These maps are wildin'. You bought Dwarf Fortress, but you don't really know how to play. Yes, that is Dwarf Fortress in a nutshell. The game is like, it used to be you could just go into the wiki and find quick start guides, and given enough failed fortresses, you would kind of eventually grok the general how to play. But I assume that the game's only gotten more complex as time went on, so I don't know how viable that is anymore. Well, the Steam version to support the main. Yeah, like that's what I should do, because good God, they absolutely deserve it. There was a while that I supported them on Patreon, but I stopped for some reason. I don't remember why. I should at least start throwing some money at them. Krug Smash. Krug Smash is so good. His illustrated videos are just a joy to watch, and he does so much weird shit. It's great. I would highly recommend Krug Smash to anybody with an interest in Dwarf Fortress. You have to get it. It's a game about dwarves and you build stuff. Fair enough. And the mega structures are certainly plentiful. You haven't really made a proper fort until you've made like a giant magma-filled dong that when the goblins come, it just pumps lava out, just flooding the entire battlefield. GF-18 capacity mod kit. Scorpion, extra ammo. I don't really feel the need to buy extra ammo for the scorpion. I still have the isolinear chipset, but blend that baby. Alright, Diego. You want the chip? You want it? Come and get it! You backstabbing! Something tells me Diego got that chip. And then he got it. Yeah, exactly. Oh my lord! Got two of these things at me? Only I had a grenade launcher. If only I had a grenade launcher. Oh. How do they disappear? That's the scary thing is... There it is. Alright, there we go. Easy! Chi-chi! Machete rounds... Assault rifle... Magnum rounds I'll always take. Where is it? This mag pulse, I swear, in the early game, the thing, I never used it because there was never any ammo for it, and now we've got more ammo than I know what to do with. It's a nice problem to have, but damn. Why don't I quickly eat 60 wheels of cheese? Man, if only I had 60 wheels of cheese. You guys ever have one of those days where you just wake up and you want to eat 60 wheels of cheese? I know I do. I wake up and I haven't eaten three times my body weight in wheels of cheese. It's just not a day that I want to be alive. Every single day. Who here hasn't eaten shredded cheese at 3 a.m. straight from the bag? Good lord. Palmer, did you stay up all night eating slices of cheese? I think I'm blind. God, I miss old Simpsons. My God! Oh, hey, little dude. These, like, Hulkobots are ridiculous. There need to not be 1,000 of these things on this level, and yet... There very much are... One hit point, esports. They just don't stop shooting. We're praising the Fallout trailer, so if you give them another year, you have a Skyrim show and another release on a random calculator. Don't tempt them. Don't tempt them, because they'll do it. Absolutely. Ain't nobody got time for more of that shit. I'm gonna go back and recharge energy and grab a heal. Bit of a hike. Let's see. Then from here, it's actually up. But no. I don't have any energy. Shit. Yeah, damn it. Let's see. Coordinates can launch you higher. Does that make it a booster? God. What if they did actually release a Skyrim show and it was just lampooning all of the Skyrim shit that everybody makes fun of? Would it be terrible, or would you have to respect them for owing up to all of their garbage? Thank you. Way to use the ladder there, bro. Good job. A plus. Skyrim horse tipping would make Shagorath go, what the fuck? I don't know. I don't know. Of all the things that needed a TV show, Fallout, not it. There was that fan-done one years ago. It was called Nuka something. Nuka Break, I think. It was okay. It was obviously a fan production, but it was watchable. Like, that was all right. But this new one's just going to be corporate bullshit. I know it is. I'm happy for the people that are excited for it, but... eh. Fill up the course of a beloved companion, make him integral, make the viewer really feel. Suddenly be dead from an arrow from a random Khajiit. Those fucking stealth archers, they're coming for the party now. Alright, let's get this shit show on the road. You sneaky little bastard. Well, where's the Hulkbot at? I know it's over here. Hell? Oh my god, there's a turret over there, I think. Oh, it's not a turret, it's a man! That's proximity mine. Yep. Dude, you blow yourself up and I can't even loot your bits. Denied. An Oblivion TV series? Oh god. Yeah, I don't really use any of the mods either. The only time I use them is if I very specifically need them at a given moment. I don't just leave them running. And it's a shame too, because some of them are actually quite good. The ballistic resistant mod in particular is... it noticeably improves your survivability, but... energy is so sparse that I just can't... rationalize having it running more often than... very rare occasions. Nothing. Ow, a whole lot of nothing. That's disappointing. Well, we'll take the scrap. Lift is disabled. All of that for a disabled lift. Well, alright. Thor over here. Requires less than 18%. Okay, how did we add marker? There we go. I'm just gonna use this to mark the doors that require security levels. Kind of at a loss as to where we're supposed to go. I mean, I guess there's a little area we missed. The man was a pile of secrets and now is a pile of secretions. Oh, God. I mean, I suppose we can get up here. Man, these boots. Having the flight on these things feels cheesy as shit. I kind of love it. Okay, so we fly up here, we hit this button over here in this inaccessible area just to make a fucking lift here. Why? Video games.